kicking out of the back of the end zone. Anything goes wrong in a situation like that, and you're giving up either a safety, 2 points for their team, or if they recover the ball in the end zone, it's a touchdown. Or if they get it just outside the end zone, their offense is going to bring it in for a touchdown. So when you're kicking out of the back of the end zone, there's no room for error. One of the first things you can't do is you can't ever step backwards. So you'll line up about a yard in front of the end line, regardless of where your snapper is. So you might be less than 14 yards. You might be as little as like 9 yards would be the minimum you are behind your snapper, and you have no choice. That means you're a lot closer to the block point, the oncoming defense who's trying to block your punt. And also, they're probably less worried about a return, and they're probably going to bring a block. They're going to send all their all those defenders at you, trying to get the ball, knock it down, and score a touchdown. So that means you have less steps to work with, less room to work with, and you have to get it off a lot faster. It's a lot more important. So in, say, at the end of a game situation, when it's a must-have punt out of the end zone, the other team, it's a must-block, they might rush all 11 guys. There's no returner down there. In a case like that, hang time is not important, but you want to do what's called a one-step punt. So you want to catch the ball and just take one step and kick. That's all you have time for. That's all the room you have for in the end zone. And you just need to get the ball off at any cost. And you also have to make sure if you get a bad snap or something, you have to field it, get the ball off, and you can't be catching it and going backwards with it at all, or trying to have a false step before you kick it. You just have to catch it, one step and kick, get the ball off. So that's kicking out of the back of the end zone.